don't do this for the riches. I'm infected, my condition is I'm always in my head. These words are my religion. I'm obsessed, it's by decision. I'ma do this till I'm dead, yeah. Set me on fire, set me on fire.
Welcome back to the video. Ooh, this one's confusing. The last 3 weeks, guys, a lot's been going on. Been extremely busy getting this project set in stone. Actually, today's the day, the first day we're actually gonna start filming this. There's just been a lot going on. If y'all are new to the channel, this is a 2002 Chevy Tahoe, tons of videos on it. Where it's come from, where I've gotten it to now. Love the truck so much, it's making me very, very broke right now because I'm just putting a lot of time and money into it. Just go back, I'm not gonna explain, but this truck was a piece of junk. There's a lot of things wrong with it. We've come a long ways with it. So to say that I built my dream truck at age 20, that is probably actually the title of this video because that's just how hard I worked for this. Today's video, we're gonna be installing a brand new lift. Like I said, I just wanna finish this truck off. Brand new tires and rims and everything to do the front end. And I'm just gonna start with saying, we started taking this truck apart the other night, and Zach's behind me, he'll be helping this video. Jordan, Alex, John, they've all done multiple lifts, and for some reason, for it to be my luck, my truck's been the hardest we've ever done. Everything is seized on this thing. I've got on this truck is from Wisconsin, and how long it's been down here, I don't know, but now I own it, so I'm kind of having to deal with it now. There's not much rust on the truck, but it is. I mean, it's 19 years old, it is old. So everything in the front end was completely seized. I mean, it won't come out. It took us, what do you think, Zach, for over a day and a half? To get everything off?
Oh yeah.
And still going. So I filmed a little bit in the beginning, just us taking off the tires and rims and starting to take off, just trying to get the upper control on, just those minor things. And it became such a pain in the butt to where I was just done filming. Just said, we have to get this stuff. I don't want to bore you guys. We're literally cutting stuff in half because I have, like I said, I have everything brand new just to redo it all, because there is no using the stuff that's came off this truck. It's too old, it's too raggedy, and I don't want it. I'll show you guys a little bit what we have for this video today. The sponsors that helped me build this truck, and where we've gotten so far, taking everything off. Hopefully today we'll start putting some new stuff on, but for the time being, let me show you what I got. Oh, we got a representative. Forgot we got the old hat, custom offset. So I'm gonna show you guys, like I said, everything we have so far for this build, the tires, the rims, everything that I ordered, and how this truck's gonna get built. So let's take this thing out. All right, y'all, so this is what we're rocking for the build. It is a lot of stuff. How to do the green for the old Lip and Bass TV. This truck right here is what is considered my job. It's what I'm trying to represent and just what's gonna get me to where I wanna be. But yeah, like I said, everything was just so wore out in this truck. I'll show you guys. I'm just in the process of doing some stuff right there. But yeah, a lot of this stuff was just so freaking wore out. It wasn't worth using again. Actually, them CVs are still good. Always keep more, but yeah, pretty much everything else, it's not looking good. Got the new CVs right there. Just new upper control arms. I mean, I tried to paint what we could. It's probably a lot of things to get room, but it is what it is. Brakes, rotors, just the whole nine yards. It's all the bolts and stuff for the lift. Philistine shocks, it's just the whole nine yards. So the tires and rims, like I said, custom offsets is sponsoring this video today. We're just a lot of thought process of what I wanted to get. I don't want to strain the truck too much. These right here are 35. These are Hilos 20 inch rims. We upgraded a little bit, still sticking with the 35s, but with the rims, I'll show you guys. The tire itself is the LT375 45 R22. It's a pretty wide tire. I mean, a lot wider than what I've had in this truck. And for the rims, these are Tiss Off Road. It's a 22 by 14s, old wide guys, but I've been looking at these for a while. Actually, was gonna get custom inserts where you see the chrome was going to be green, but that would have taken at least 10 weeks to get shipped out, and these guys were already helping me with this build so much that we could just get these to me a lot faster. Same with Super Lift over there. But yeah, it's what we're rolling with. It's a much bigger tire than what I got right now, but like I said, I think she's gonna look good. This is what my truck's looking like right now. Had to strip everything off. I mean, total so far we've broke maybe $200 worth of parts, but we got those replaced. When I say y'all, everything was just seized into this truck. It was just, it wasn't good. It's the same thing, everything's pretty much off. Then we still have the whole entire rear, and looking at these, springs right here, they are a lot bigger than my stock ones, and these can get very dangerous having to take those out from the rear. That's gonna be fun. And also too, we got two brand new 2.5-inch keys, so technically the lift is a 6-inch lift, but we could get around 8. I'm not gonna max them out all the way because currently that's what's maxed out on this truck and it rides like shit. So yeah, brand new keys, these are custom all set too, so. Yeah, a lot of things. I don't want to bore you guys with just us taking everything off because it's a lot of work and it's very tedious because nothing's just coming off the way we want it to. So we're going to get everything off. Hopefully, like I said, Zach and I are just working a couple more things. And then Alex, Zach, Jordan, and John, like the main guys for this build because they know what they're doing. I know a lot about fishing. Y'all learned a lot about like motor work and stuff. But, like this whole lift thing is just, it's kind of out of my league. I'm here to help with support and film and bring you guys along with me, but yeah, they're gonna be the ones really doing this build for me. I'll just be filming it and just helping out when I can. So Alex and John will be here soon. So once they come here, y'all, give you guys some more updates and hopefully start putting some stuff on this truck. All right, y'all, it's another day back out here in the shop. Let me just show y'all what we got going on with the freaking mess. Oh, Lordy. Tant Man's with me.
Not much of a mess out here.
He's gonna be helping out, it's just me and him today. It is now day 3 and we're still taking stuff apart. That's how bad this freaking truck is, taking everything off. Our last step is just to take off this one pitman arm, and it's the one that's got the grooves on my driver's side, which is, it's already hard to get these off. Everything is just older and it's just so seized.
Seized, everything's rusted on.
Thanks, Alex. That's why we're trying to replace everything, because Alex is right, I won't doubt him on that. A lot of stuff is rusted on this truck. So I had to rent a tool for this, guys, and we actually broke the freaking tool. I'll show you what we're dealing with. It's dark, but that is a pitman arm, and that's the tool right here, and it's right now, it's stuck on. We gotta try to get that off. After that piece comes off, we can actually try to start putting some more stuff on. I'm gonna show you, hopefully, what's gonna help us get this done a little bit better. Got the reinforcements. This is a $178 kit that I rented, so hopefully this will do it for us. Once we get this off, I'm gonna pick this back up, and then hopefully, just hopefully, we can start putting this on. Ooh, that looks good. Last thing, and then we're gonna, like I said, just get the stuff done and hopefully jump into this. Alex has been one of the biggest helps of this build. He's done a ton of lifts before. He actually had one of the cleanest Tahoes around, so that's why just he knows about my truck. He's done his lift. So, I mean, he's a big help. Without Alex right now, I could not be getting any of this done because, like I said, I'm a fishing channel. I know a lot about, little about motors, but this stuff, I mean, I'm just lost. And if y'all could see, look at all of this. I mean, it's just a lot, so. Leave Alex's Instagram in the description. Go give him a follow. You can see his truck now. Actually, I can show y'all. That's Alex's truck right there. It's a super, super clean truck. 9-inch lift on 37 grabs. It's a very, very clean truck. Y'all can see his lift right there. Yeah, it's very expensive. He does all of this by himself. He knows a lot about him. So he's teaching me a little bit. Finally got it out. Pitman arm is installed. Now we're moving to the front cross member.
Mine needs to be hit this way.
It was kind of tough getting between where it's got to sit in place. And Alex said Jordan hit it to my side a little bit, and Jordan's side dropped and went straight down and hit Alex's brand new phone that is now shattered. What do you say about that, Alex?
Jordan.
I don't know what else can go wrong. I really don't. Gotta keep on pushing. Alex is gonna get a new phone. Cross members in now, putting in the inner tie rods. Pushing in the upper control arms right now, and then we'll probably wait for Alex to come back. It'll be like the last step we do. Broke the camber plates, taking them out because they were plastic, and Wayne got some new metal ones, so those are getting replaced. Got some more reinforcements. Alex isn't back yet. John just came by. He's gonna help put this diff in. Rear going up. We just came back to the shop. We're kind of multitasking two things right now. I'm gonna show you guys what we have going on. It's hard to film. I'm trying to film and like it's just you need people to do this. But I mean, I'm trying to do the best I can. It's a hard thing to film. Get the upper control arms in, back cross member, front. We got the brackets that mount. Where's the light at? There we go. We got the brackets that mount to the diff. We had to do a lot of cutting and shaving. Another bracket all the way right there that y'all can see kind of mounts to the front cross member. Just a lot going on. It's just we had to get past all of this. It's just been a big pain in the butt. Gordon's installing right now the new CVs. We gotta put the spacers in with it. Looks like a spacer for an actual tire. Just about to impact those. I'm trying to get John.
I got him.
And Christian up there. That second drop down bracket's going in. Exact point to it, sway bar bushings. Those were wore out really bad. I think that's why my truck was squeaking, plus everything that was freaking seized. Now we're throwing the brackets in. Same thing on that side. I'm trying to like multitask. Like, I don't want to show you guys both sides. Just try to capture what we're doing on each, but it's just coming together. Upper control arm is attached.
Gotta set the torsion key right, so the torsion bar has the right amount of pressure. It's almost maxed out.
That tool helps so much.
Yes, sir.
We got Christian over there working on that side. Tire rod end's going on this side. What's left? We got a shock right here. We're throwing Bilstein shocks into the truck. I know, it's all coming together, guys. I was really getting nervous in the beginning, but we're pulling it off. This side, the rotor's on. I hook up the brakes. I got brand new brakes to show you guys here in a second. This side's looking good. Pads on. Press them in.
Yeah, the brakes are the same time.
That step over here is a Bilstein shock. Hand it off to Jordan. Snug that puppy in. All right, y'all, everything's on this side. Y'all grab a tire, just pull it over here. Get ready to see how this thing's gonna sit.
You gotta jack it up in front.
We got
so it is the next day. That is how the truck looked, stock. And that is what we're rolling with right now. Everything's in, the tires are kind of a little bowed out, but it's just, we gotta get the alignment. Not many shops around here can do 22x14, so I'm gonna have to throw on stock tires or the tires I had on before, get in the line, then we'll throw these back on. But it's honestly, it's not that bad. Steering wheel straight, I mean, they're wide. Very, very wide. I mean, that is the truck all the way up there. I'm 6'2", when you sit inside, you can only see my head. It's up there. It's that side. A little comparison for the tires back there to these now. They are out there. Right now we're trying to take out the rear end. How's it looking, Alex? Not good on my tip, but how's it looking, Alex?
It's self-explanatory.
Looking pretty good. It's got a lot of seized bolts.
Just like the front end?
Yeah, a lot of rust.
Step by step, Alex is gonna explain what we have to do just because I have to run around and grab parts and we're kind of both taking this apart, so what we gotta do, Alex?
First, we start off by taking the upper control arms off. Then we're gonna take the shocks off, the sway bar end links, and the middle track bar. And then we should lower it and the spring should come out.
And if y'all could see, stock springs, then lift springs. Much bigger and they're very compressed in there. Like I said, y'all, step by step, we're gonna get her. Johnny boy.
Howdy.
This side's done. Alex is working on the other. Boy, getting to it. Working hard. Rear springs out. Look at the size difference from them guys. Little babies. I was just putting on the rubber caps that hold it in place. Well, it was going too smooth for something not to happen. Y'all see that dripping. That is my one of my brake lines for the back. It's not good.
Rust.
We just disconnected the brake line right here. Lucky enough, Zach actually had a spare one from us doing his rear end. So it should match up everything. Very lucky that he had this, because if not, I'd be kind of screwed for tonight. We're gonna keep on moving with the rear lift, but yeah, at least we got that for backup.
Oh, Alex.
Turn around, Alex.
How have you been hurt?
You all right?
Yeah.
We had a little
more on this.
Yeah, a little problem. Jack slid out. The rear end fell on Alex's leg and kind of crushed it, but he's back walking. He's all right. Springs are in. They're looking good, looking straight, and somewhere, y'all, getting somewhere. Shock going in. Working over here now, getting this shock in. Reading up on some directions just to make sure everything's going right. Just checking up on this last little piece right there. And yeah, y'all, we're making some progress. Sticking with it. So we're putting the last rear shock right now. After this, I have to mess around with the brake line that we broke. Please, Zach's fit, so we're just gonna put that in it. John was the man and grabbed me some brake fluid, so we'll bleed the brakes and hopefully go from there. So a lot's happened up here at Tim Extreme right now. It's a local shop. They put on lifts and they put on tires and stuff, and there's lots going on. The truck is done. They can't align 22x14, so we have the stock tires on. Where's that light? There it is. We have the stock tires back on the truck. Got it yesterday, was gonna go drive, and I'm getting a clicking sound. I think it's just because the truck is so out of alignment that it's doing that, but yeah, it's out of my hands now, y'all. I'm gonna show you what the truck looks like now and just let Team Extreme put it in their hands. Hopefully by Monday I'll have the truck back and clicking should be gone. I mean, the truck is pretty tall. She's up there. The keys are halfway. It rode pretty good, except the steering wheel doing this back and forth. It was a little challenging. Like I said, y'all, Team Extreme, they're gonna take care of me. It's now day like six. Got it back from the lineman shop. It actually said it was gonna be there to Monday, but they called me like 2 hours later. I got the truck back super early, so the last and final step is just to put the new tires on, and we're having a little bit of a problem right now. I don't know if it's because my truck is up so high with them little narrow tires, like the stock ones I had on it, but the truck has a ton of sway, and yeah, it's kind of dangerous. Not dangerous, I know how to drive this truck, but it's just like, I don't think it should be doing that, so hopefully having tires like this, the lineman shop said it too, having some stance with the lift should help a little bit more, and that's what these tires right here are for. So we're gonna throw them on. Let's get to it. The truck is done for now. She looks extremely good. Christian and I had to just cut more than what we wanted, but just to make sure, if you're gonna cut into that, you know, you wanna make sure you can clear it, because that is metal. If you were to hit a bump and it hits that, you could pop a tire. So cleared that side as much, could made it like tighten up a little bit. We'll still go back and do a little bit more, but then you got that side. It's not terrible. We made it work, but the freaking truck looks good. I'm gonna show you guys an angle in the back of how wide this thing is. That's the truck sticking out like that. I mean, this thing is freaking wide, a lot wider than what she used to be. And having some stance now, ooh, she looks good. They're really good. It's getting dark, y'all, so we'll pull the truck out, and I'm gonna pick this up tomorrow, and I'll show you guys some better clips of what we built. All right, y'all, we're in the truck right now. We've had like 3 days of non-stop rain. I'm talking non-stop, so to get more shots of the truck, gonna be a little hard right now. I wanna get the content out to you guys. It's been a while since I've posted. There's a lot going on. I got something, another big thing coming up. So that's where I'm keeping my head right now, guys, trying to get the content out to you guys. I had, like I said, something big coming up, so more content will be coming soon, hopefully on a better schedule. But to say that we've built our dream truck at age 20, it is just unbelievable. Support, everything I get from you guys, just means the freaking world to me, so thank you. Big shout out to Custom Offsets and Super Lift for helping with this build. Same with RGB Halo Kits. All the sponsors that have helped this video has got this truck to where it's at today. So more to come, more sponsors to come. We're gonna freaking keep on building this truck. I got some more ideas for this baby right here. So y'all, it is coming soon. Like I said, y'all, stay with me. Leave a comment down below. Let's keep the support and everything positive going. I really appreciate it, guys. Till next time, with Best.